Welcome and good afternoon. Today we are in Mirkwood with King Thranduil, and we lost a bet.
We sure did, with Bilbo.
That means that it's time for the dreaded fanfiction review.
Let's start this with a fanfiction called...
It's called Blooming Heart by Plavkovi. I don't know if I pronounced that right. The summary is... Thorin and Thranduil got lost and had to hide from pouring rain in Hobbit abode. Thorin is trying to resist Thranduil's beauty. But seeing an elf so different from what he knows about him, smiling, laughing and happy, makes him realize how he feels about him. They can't leave because of the weather, and one more night is finally bringing what they craved for from the very first time they met. I look forward to this. This is gonna be so much fun.
Should you read this?
That pouring rain was awful, at least for Thorin. The tall elf walked beside the muddy and rain-soaked dwarf.
I like this fabric already. You're cold and muddy and short.
Seemed to enjoy the drops of summer rain very much. Your turn, sweetheart.
Rain is so refreshing.
From the side, and Thorin rolled his eyes. Elvish stupidities, he thought, and the elf just smiled, still enjoying the weather. No wonder it pissed Thorin off even more. No matter what he was doing, he always found himself inferior, uncouth, unwillingly beside the elven king. Too slow, too small, too noisy.
I just love this one. It's great.
What are you trying to do here? Are you trying to make me look like an idiot?
Keep going. Don't mind him, he's just grumpy.
Of course he knew it wasn't true. Most probably all beings of Middle-earth felt like this in front of elves, especially such stubborn and proud ones as dwarves. They walked for hours now. The moon lingered behind a wall of clouds, and the pouring rain soon had become their faithful companion. No matter how hard Thorin tried, he was still stumbling on rocks and roots of trees in the darkness that reached on the road around Green Hills, and he could only envy Thranduil and his elf eyes. Thorin wanted to rest, for they had walked so long, but he didn't want to give that elf the pleasure to hear him complain. It was enough already that they were lost just because Thranduil had listened to the self-confident Thorin and his poor sense of direction.
Oh yes, I like this, it's very... realistic.
I will find you. Don't say anything. If they were deep in the tunnels under the mountain, he would have found the directions easily. But on huge plains above the earth, the dwarf just wasn't a good guide. It was his stubbornness that had brought them here, and he just hoped that they would find some shelter soon. Before the dwarf could finish his thought, tiny lanterns beside rounded doors appeared in the distance, laying over the hills, hobbit holes. His heart lit up with happiness when the elven king pointed to them, Thorin glad at him.
It's your line.
I see them, he retorted, and rushed to the nearest door. Thranduil shrugged and followed his companion. When they were close enough, they could see little people through an adorable window of the first hole. There sat an old hobbit at a table and chatted with his friends. Behind him, there were keys with numbers. It seemed like they had come to the right place. I will ask for accommodation, the dwarf said and walked forward to the door when Thranduil grabbed him and pinned him against the wall.
Have you lost your mind? It seems that rain wiped off the last tiny piece of sense you had. Of course, march inside, dwarf from the Blue Mountains, with weapons, with gems, with royal clothing, you'd be more than incompetuous. ambitious. Oh, I need glasses.
Getting old.
Getting old. I've been old for 2,000 years now.
Frandil said sarcastically and crossed his arms over his chest.
No one must see us, and no one must know we are here, and who we are.
He added determinedly and Sworin rolled his eyes with a growl, frowning into the darkness. They're hobbits, he said simply, as if it was an excuse for not being worried at all.
You've already underrated Master Baggins, and you were always surprised.
Replied the tall elf with a gaze that revealed that he wasn't about to give up so easily. Thorin growled quietly. He just wanted to sit at the warm fireplace inside and dry his clothes with everything he had. So he agreed, but he couldn't stop frowning. How was it possible that the elven king was soaked to the bones but still looked so splendid?
I always do.
It didn't even seem that the drops were soaking into his soft skin. They rather just caressed his face, happy to have rare privilege to touch him in the light of the lantern. What is this? Who wrote this? Is this an elf? Is this the elf that is... No. No. Stop it.
Don't be so shy.
I will find you.
Write one on your own, then.
Frandil sucks the end.
Beautiful.
Thorin had to calm down. Each time when he started to think about the Elven King in this way, he quickly tried to find something that would make him forget that he was ever started to think about Frandil in the first place. Fine, I'll steal one of those keys. Wait, Thorin was already about to put down his knapsack, but a slender arm on his chest made him stop.
Indeed, you have lost your mind.
The elf shook his head in disbelief, and Thorin stabbed him with an angry glare.
Even in this rain, I would hear you 100 miles. They would see immediately. Let me take care of this.
The Elven King promised and put down his quiver and bow. You don't need a quiver and bow.
Why not?
Because...
Well, I do fancy this sword. Even though I am quite excellent at bow. Who do you think taught Legolas?
I would believe that when I see it. And besides, Killy is the best with the bow.
I doubt it.
Quiver a bow to Thorin's heavy boots, carrying nothing but his long, elegant sword. He would rather have Bilbo's magic ring on his finger, but this time he decided to trust the elf's skills. While Thorin's soaked mood was falling to the freezing point, Frandil came back with a key in his hand and a smug smile on his lips. Lips that called after Thorin to taste them. No. No. While the dwarf tried to unlock the door, it seemed Frandil was excited as well, even though, unlike soaked Thorin, he looked like marble carved by the gods. The dwarf barely looked around and immediately went to make a fire. Soon, his wet clothes were hanging on the shelf of the fireplace, drying, while he put on dry clothes from his knapsack. Only Frandil stood there in his wet clothes because he didn't have something to change. Thorin gave him an amused smile from the armchair. What's wrong? Wet, isn't it? You are the one who didn't want to lug the knapsack, Thorin smirked spitefully. But Frandil challenged him with a derisive gaze. He put his hands on his robe, whispering a few words in a language that Thorin didn't understand. And in that moment, his clothes got brighter, and they had dried immediately.
Did you say something?
The elf smirked, but Thorin just frowned and stared at the fireplace, taking a whiff of his pipe. The elf just laughed tinklingly and went to the kitchen. Thorin couldn't help but follow him with a surprised gaze. He could swear he had never heard such laughter from the Elven King before. It seemed that the rain had a strange effect on elves, but he was glad. It gave him hope that Frandil maybe wasn't the ice statue without a heart that he often thought him to be.
There are some herbs. Would you like tea, Thorin?
Called the elf from the kitchen. Thorin was just astonished how attentive that man suddenly was, even though the hospitality of elves was nothing new to him. Yes, please, thank you, the dwarf replied politely as well. Frandil let the water heat for the herbal tea and went to explore another room in the abode and found himself regretting that the elf still hadn't hit his head in the ceiling.
Bad and good news,
he spoke, stealing Thorin's attention.
There's just a double-sized bed,
he said, and Thorin growled.
But it's too small for an elf, and even for a dwarf, so we will need to sleep on the floor,
he added quickly to cheer Thorin up. And that is supposed to be good news, Thorin lifted an eyebrow. He definitely didn't consider sleeping on the hard wooden floor as good news. However, Thranduil seemed to be surprised by his question, and a playful smile appeared on his strict face.
Shouldn't it? What, did you want to share a bed with me?
He smirked, and Thorin could swear there was a sparkle in these cold eyes. A sparkle he had never seen before. He turned away and murmured some impolite phrases in Cuzdul. He didn't mean it. He would never dare to be that close to that beautiful creature. The elf just laughed again and brought a cup of tea to Thorin. The tea smelled amazingly and warmed his heart. Thanks, Thorin murmured, and the elf nodded, disappearing into the bathroom. He surveyed the bed to assure himself that he really couldn't sleep there, and indeed, hobbit sizes were too small, even for a dwarf. Especially for such a tall dwarf as Thorin Oakenshield was. I actually am the tallest dwarf in the company.
That's like saying you're taller than all of the ants in the forest. It's not a compliment.
Well, he took what he could. Duvets, blankets, pillows, there were a lot, and made two comfortable nests out of them, heading in front of the warm fireplace. Only when he looked at his finished work, he realized there wasn't much space between the two nests. Actually, there was almost no space between them. Thorin was on the right and Thranduil on the left, because he had put more blankets and pillows there to make it longer. Damn it, the younger king growled.
Oh, king.
Yes.
I wouldn't use that word in per se.
If you hadn't worn your crown, I would smack you with the book. But before he could destroy what he made, the door of the bathroom opened, and when Thranduil came out, the dwarf was already sitting in the armchair, taking a sip of his tea, pretending everything was perfectly alright.
Thank you for the bed,
the elf said complacently. The elf said complacently when he saw that the dwarf even made his bed longer in elf size.
That's sort of sweet, actually.
Thorin just nodded, still watching the fire in the fireplace. The elven king came closer and tried to tie his long silver hair into a ponytail, but it was difficult for him because of the wound on his shoulder. When did you get a wound?
I suppose it was pre-fanfic.
He took a leather twine between his teeth and tried to sleek his strands into one palm.
I hope you're enjoying your tea.
Thranduil murmured, frowning slightly at the floor, while he was trying to force his hair where he wanted it to be. It was when Thorin finally looked up at the tall elf, and there was no chance how he could keep his mouth closed. His jar fell down without realizing it, and suddenly all words faded into nothingness. Everything faded, everything, and nothing could compare to the magnificence that pleased his eyes. The elven king just wore tight leggings with the color of bright gray wood, temptingly coping the perfect shape of his thighs. But this wasn't the worst thing, his skin. The white marble that shone more in the darkness than stars could have, even more than the Arkham stone itself. No!
I'm more beautiful than Arkham stone.
No! Who wrote this?
Say it!
I will still find you.
This is you, I can see your name, and you think I'm more pretty than an Arkenstone. So sweet. You lost a bet, so you have to keep your promise.
Stupid Bilbo. His chest was bare, and Thorin could see it for the first time in his life. The King of Dwarves had been used to imagining it countless of times. I have never imagined his chest! But none of his hot dreams.
You have to imagine my chest, because you can't see it from your height. What's happening? What did I miss?
The King of Dwarves had been used to imagine it countless times, but none of his hot dreams could compare to reality now. The elf's muscles were bigger than he had expected, thinking of his thin figure, but just slightly and delicately shaped. The truth was his body was perfect.
That is the proof.
Actually, it was only then when Thorin realized the whole perfection of Thandil's lips. Oh, Mahal. He wanted to taste them so badly. The sweet scent of autumn, sweet song of intoxicating wine.
Yes, continue.
No, I don't want to.
Please don't make me.
Yes, he was sure that was how these lips tasted. I want to crawl down into a tiny hole and never come up to the surface again after reading this sentence. Thorin's eyes wandered lower to the delicate neck and wanted to graze there forever, but they slid down to pink nipple. No.
Yes, this is a bit uncomfortable for me.
It is. Well, in that case. Down to pink nips, quickly, hard and tempting, and even lower to seductive hips, and Thorin couldn't help himself but to imagine those delightful hips moving against him as he felt a sudden warmth in his crotch. He didn't.
I feel naked.
I feel so used.
You feel used? Who's the naked one who's being irate by a filthy dwarf?
Hey! You're dressing provocatively. He didn't dare to dream of what was under them. And what tasted you?
Continue. We both are dogs here.
He didn't dare to dream of what was under them, and what tasted you was hidden under these leggings. It was too much for him.
Thorin. Thorin!
Thunder called to wake the dwarf from his dreams, and there was an incredibly amused smile on his face. Smile that Thorin had never seen before, and the only thing he could do was to return it, not knowing how silly it looked like.
Will you finally tell me why you're pouring your tea on your pants?
The elf chuckled, and the dazed Thorin woke up after just a few more seconds. He looked down to find out that he poured almost a whole cup of warm tea on his already hot groin. Damn it, damn it! He jumped up, cursing everything. He angrily put the cup back on the table and tried to kill the wet spot on his trousers with his gaze. Damn the elf!
So, who is the one who doesn't have any dry clothes?
Thrandil teased. Damn stupid elf. Thorin fought and stabbed him with a hateful glare.
Wait,
said Thrandil soothingly, and moved to Thorin with one graceful movement. He knelt before him and put his hand on his thighs. His thumb almost touching the balls of his throat. If you ever touch me...
Why would I ever lay my hands on you?
Ever touch me... I will chop off your head with my sword.
You can't reach for the hundreds of times.
If you're kneeling, then I will be able to reach.
Oh, well, get me to kneel like I'm doing now, and then you can chop my head off.
Well, I will pour hot tea into my lap. He had to hold back a moan that the big palm squeezing his hot thighs gave him. The elf's lips whispered quietly words of another spell, and Thorin immediately wished those lips were around his heart.
I won't read this anymore. Now I put my foot down.
His heart and hard. Thranduil stood up, leaving the dwarf's pants dry again. I want to read what's happening further down.
Oh, I like this. King of Dwarf blushed like a young maiden.
Oh, no.
No, this is too much for me.
Wait, we're gonna get to the good stuff.
No, this... I put everything down.
Make love to me, Thorin.
No!
Thranduil panted softly and was all the other king needed to hear. The smaller man rolled them over, so he was on top, resting between his long...
That's enough. That's quite enough. I'm a married man. Let's just...
Yeah, you're married to me.
Let's go on, shall we? We should take another...
You want me to take it so badly? Breathe it out.
No.
This is actually quite amusing. You're turning into a little maiden yourself, Thranduil.
I'm far from a maiden.
You're swearing
I have son. I have a son. Show respect.
Hey, Legolas. You and...
Legolas is not allowed to watch this.
Me and father are gonna fuck.
No!
I hope you're watching this, Legolas. Well, this has been...
uncomfortable.
Very uncomfortable. I will go and crawl down to that hole now. Thank you for glorifying this oath.
I will not say it's glorifying, I will say it's truthful.
Not really. And thank you for writing such nice words about me. The few words that were actually about me that was positive.
Well, if people are keeping us together, I can see why the focus would be more on me.
Why?
Is it obvious?
I mean, I'm gorgeous.
Oh, well, that's gorgeous, thank you. Stupidity. I like that one. It was very beautiful in Britain, with the nature, and I could feel the surrounding. Also, it was very realistic.
No, it wasn't. But it was very beautiful in Britain. So we applaud your work.
Stop playing with your hair, you're not a child.
But if anyone's giving...
Thank you so much for watching. That will be all for us. Are you going to say goodbye?
To all of you out there, if you ever see this video, you must know that we were forced.
Good point.
I will now go and hide in a corner and never ever speak of the name of Thranduil ever again. That is for all. Goodbye.
Are you making it rain? If I have pink ball.
Hey! You're dressing too long.
My dress should have nothing to do with the way people treat me.
We're doing this every Friday.
Yeah, every Friday.
Some shy tea.
Yeah, and cookies. Wait, I'm red. I have to... Do I look fancy?
No, you look fabulous. You look flawless. Like the art.
Oh, thank you, dear. I know I look beautiful.
No.